Hello, my YouTubers. I just have to tell you about the coolest case I've had in years. So last night, a guy comes in with the chief complaint of having an eggplant for a penis. You heard that right. His penis was the size of an eggplant. I mean, this thing was about, and I'm not making the Fishers joke where they exaggerate or whatever. This thing was about 10 inches long and probably had a diameter about that big. I mean, maybe that big. This thing was huge. Why? Well, here's the story. His partner had put a penile ring. You heard that right. Imagine a ring for a big thumb. So I'm going to show you a picture of what it looked like. Put in all the way at the base of the penis at 4 in the morning when they were doing stuff. He's tired, he falls asleep, wakes up in the mid-afternoon with a swollen penis. But it wasn't purple, it wasn't, I guess it was swollen and painful and all that stuff. But he starts trying to take it out, it was jelly, he does this, he does that, it's not getting any better, to the point where it starts changing coloration and it gets purple. So it starts getting very painful, and he shows up to the emergency department around 8 o'clock at night. So this thing had been there a long, long time. When I looked at that, I've never seen anything like that. I mean, it's just humongous. And then I finally get to the ring, and I look at it and stuff, and I'm thinking, this is titanium. Not just like metal, gold, or plastic. This is titanium ring. I don't know if you know anything about titanium rings, but they're supposed to be indestructible. I often have nightmares thinking, what would happen if I crush my finger or hit myself, I get swollen up, even just bit by a bug or a wasp and it gets all swollen. How the heck are they going to take that ring out? Because in the ER, we have these tools called ring cutters, special device you put underneath the ring. It has a blade, it cuts through, gets the ring out. But this is for gold rings and titanium rings. I've gone to jewelers and I've asked them, hey, how would you take that out? How would you break that? And what they've told me was that these rings shatter. They break if put enough pressure on them. And I said, well, how would you do that? He says, well, you know, if you hit them dead on, they break. Can you even imagine us trying to hit that with the eggplant there for the penis? So that wouldn't work. Then I recalled that we had a paramedic here in our hospital who was able to break a regular ring off a finger by using one of those big jaws of life kind of tools used to break into buildings and break chains and things like that. So I happened to run to by one of the other paramedics who was in the department, and he knew him. He knew he was working one of the fire stations. So we call him up and say, come here right away, right? And all this, I'm trying to call urology. I'm going to try to transfer this patient because there's nothing I can do for this if we can get the ring out. So I'm trying to transfer out. Just to give him some relief, I did a pudendal block. I just went to the base of the penis. I just injected some lidocaine around it so it would get some relief of pain. And certainly it helped. But it's just way, way too painful. Then I thought, okay, well, maybe if I do like you treat priapism, if you put a needle in the cavernous part of the penis, then I can draw blood, deflate it, and then we can remove it, right? So I tried that, but the blood was coagulated; it wasn't coming out. It didn't work. So finally, we find in our own hospital, somebody comes from the OR with a tool that looks pretty much like that. But even though it was big enough to grab the ring, it skid. It wasn't really holding it to the point where we could do it. And I forgot. The other issue was, how do you protect the skin? How do you protect from this big thing coming down on a tiny little ring and grabbing it, right? So invention, trying to figure out what to do. I took a tongue blade. I look at the tongue and stuff. I broke it in half, and I was able to put that underneath the ring to protect the skin underneath, and I was able to take this caliper, so this big thing, put it right there. Now, so somebody else, a paramedic, was holding this big tool, and he was used to strength. And we had a couple of tries because it kept skidding. So finally, I just grabbed it. I hold it next to the ring and the tip, and I was like really right there holding it while he's putting all this pressure and whatnot. And then all of a sudden, literally, the ring shattered. It broke in two big pieces and some little pieces. One of the pieces hit me in the face. The other one flew off, and the guy was like, "Ah!" because he felt so much better. And dude, I was high-fiving the paramedic. I was pumped up. This is literally the most coolest procedure or thing I've done in years. You go to emergency medicine and you want to save a life, save a limb, do things that are cool and really make a difference. It doesn't get much more of a difference than this. I mean, I'm going to be pumped up for months. And well, how did the patient do? Well, we're still trying to transfer the guy. The penis started kind of coming back to normal size. It never did come back to normal size, but it got pink. The purple color, which was a deep, deep purple color, started going away. He still has some ecchymosis, some deep-seated bruises on the penis, but eventually it got much better to the point where he was able to urinate, and we canceled the transfer. Watch him a little longer. Yes, I talked to the urologist again. Has an appointment tomorrow to follow up, and but he did well, and we did well, and we saved his manhood, literally. So this was the coolest case I've done in forever, and I just want to share it with you all. So yeah.